Dr. Levy, thank you so much for joining us here today. And I wonder if you can tell me a little bit about the implantable miniature telescope for AMD patients and how far it's really come over the years.
I was first exposed to the implantable miniature telescope in 2002 when I was asked to be part of a five-year FDA trial. At that time, we had no treatment for patients with advanced, dry, age-related macular degeneration. We performed this trial at 28 centers throughout the United States, and it was for patients with visual acuities between 2080 and 2800 and had bilateral dry, stable macular degeneration. We implanted the telescope in their worst seeing eye, and we followed them for first 2 years and then subsequently 5 years. What we found on average was between a 2.5 and 3 line visual improvement at the 2 year period of time and 2.5 lines of visual improvement at the 5 year time. The FDA took its time to approve the device, looking over the data, and it was subsequently improved for implantation in the United States in 2010. At that time, we went back and looked at our data and found there were things we could do better. First of all, the topical therapies that we give after cataract surgery had markedly improved. Steroids and the non-steroidals are many times more potent. The other is, as we became experienced in inserting the device, we found that our operative time and our incisions were better. Also, we found that post-operative visual training is mandatory, almost like a patient who gets a new hip. If they don't go to post-operative rehabilitation, they never learn how to walk correctly. Finally, the other thing we noticed is keeping the implant in the better seeing eye and not taking out the contralateral cataract for about a year maximizes the visual improvement. Plus having the right patient, a well-motivated patient who wants to regain their vision. I think it's very important. I might add that what we are creating by treating patients with wet macular degeneration is a large cohort of patients who are going to have advanced dry macular degeneration with geographic atrophy. And this device gives us an option how to treat them afterwards.